Using a vector shape or text as a starting point, the contour fill tool is used to simulate a gradient effect that can then be applied with tool paths. With this vector shape selected, we begin by choosing Transform Menu, Contour Fill, Internal. The contour fill controls will appear in the smart bar. On a side note, the controls are similar when performing an external contour fill. Our intent is to create a grayscale bitmap, and for this reason, we set the start color and end color to black and white. If you need to change these color pickers, then clicking will open the color selection dialog. You can either click to choose a suitable color, adjust the hue like so, click to choose a shop palette color, or set a specific RGB color. We then adjust the number of steps and the width between steps, which will determine the smoothness of the gradient effect that we get in the on-screen preview. A high number of thinly spaced steps should be effective, though the settings will vary according to how large the design is. In most cases, you will want to click the Blend button as opposed to the spectrum up-down buttons that are used with color bitmaps. Normally, the contour fill feature will produce vectors, but clicking the render button will produce a bitmap. For example, setting the color depth to 256 gray will create a grayscale bitmap. The resolution field indicates the bitmap quality, which you should set according to your job. As a general guideline, a resolution of 75 is considered low quality, 150 would be medium quality, and 300 or more would be high quality. However, please note that more processing time is required when setting a high resolution. If you need the contour fill to fade into transparency, then enable the opacity settings at the far right. For our example, we will use the relief fill feature to produce the bitmap that blends into a black background. So for now, we can turn render off. Click close to finish editing the contour fill. We want to create a black background, so choose Layout Menu, Create Plate Size Object. This will create a rectangle shape that is equal in dimension to the plate size. In the Shop palette, click Black to set the fill color. From the Edit menu, choose Select All to ensure that the entire design has been selected. Then choose Engrave menu, Create Tool Path, Relief Fill. For these settings in the Relief Fill dialog, it is sufficient to say that cutting depths will vary according to the light and dark areas of the design. For more information about this dialog, see the training video that specifically discusses Relief Fill. For now, these settings are good, so we click OK to create the tool paths. After the tool paths have been created, we can choose View Menu, Show 3D, to preview how this job will look when output. And seen here is the result of machining some signboard material.